What do you think we will be discussing after our broadcast tonight, Daniel?
I think we're going to look at the intrigue inside the NFC West. This was a doormat division for a while.
Yep.
And now when you look at it, Seattle's got two picks. So pressure on them to find somebody to fill the role with Frank Clark leaving.
Mm-hmm.
They've got two first-rounders. You look at the top of the draft, they go 1-2.
Yes.
So not only – that's, to me, the interesting discussion about Kyler Murray. You not only take Kyler Murray one, quarterbacks back-to-back years – in my opinion, you gift wrap the best defensive player in the draft to a team inside your division who's going to be playing against Kyler Murray.
Interesting.
So you've got that intrigue and that connection there inside that division, and then you've got the team that was in the Super Bowl.
The defending NFC champs.
Picking at the bottom of the first round, who's got a little bit of age in the offensive line, and do they want to take one there? Do they try and trade back? I think it's a fascinating division.
What was that number I asked you during our combine coverage?
21.
You say there will be 21 I asked you during our combine coverage, how many defensive players are going to be chosen in the first round of the draft? Because they were just jumping out of the gym and running like speed burners at ridiculous weights. And you said 21. Do you feel like that will be the case now?
That would be. I think the record's 19, so that would be big-time news if that does happen.
But now here we are
when
on
you
the
start
draft
getting
day.
To it, when you start getting to it, here's the thing that would challenge that. I think you make a case 21 of the top 32 players in the draft are defensive players.
Right.
We have so many young quarterbacks in the NFL right now with average to below average offensive lines, which is going to elevate those linemen up. And we could see a little bit of a run on the offensive line. Those guys maybe even going where they're evaluated because, look, if you've got Deshaun Watson and you're sitting there in the 20s and the top tackles are gone, which I think will take place, you almost have to reach for an offensive lineman. He cannot get hit like that another year. You have to invest in the offensive line.
I mean, they
line.
Have to. The Texans have to go.
And I hear corner. They need corners. I'm like, that's great. You have to protect Deshaun Watson, number one. That's it.
But I got to tell you, it's funny. It's almost like an AFC South ritual. It was the Colts for so many years, and now the Texans, where we're sitting on a draft set saying they've got to take an offensive lineman. They have to take an offensive lineman, and then they don't. Well, until the Colts finally did last year with this future Hall of Famer from Notre Dame, Big Q. He's nasty. So, but you have to see, you have to understand the importance of what it is. I mean, Andrew Luck was like Santiago from A Few Good Men. He was not to be touched. You know, he was ordered, and he was hardly touched last year.
Yeah.
So that's. And it starts with stuff that you see tonight.
I hadn't packed a thing.
He hadn't packed a single thing.
There's no way Mayock gets that, by the way.
I know.
Zero chance.
By the way, that's another reason why I'm excited for you for tonight. Like, it was either Stripes or the Sugar Hill Gang or nothing else. He didn't understand anything else.
Actual references tonight.
Actual pop culture
references. Who's going to do it? You, Lieutenant Weinberg?
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download the Rich Eisen Show app.